Nah, we're not answering that. Not answering that one. There you go.
How did you get into event planning? So I went to a college on the very southern part of Indiana, and I told them I wanted to do event planning. They threw me in public relations. And then I did a year down there, and then I came back to Indianapolis, and they had a degree in tourism, conventions, and event management. Did tons of internships. One, if any of you are familiar with the Indianapolis 500, being held in Indiana, one of the biggest sporting events in the country, I planned their 500 festival parade back in 2009. Best internship ever, and then I got a internship at a huge venue coordinating weddings. And then I went to one of my professors the last year of college and said, hey, I want a 9-to-5 job where I can coordinate events. So I worked at a law firm for 8 years, yeah, where I did the wedding on the side, the wedding business on the side, and then it just grew, and then I was able to do the wedding planning business for 2 years, or full time for the I quit my full time job 2 years ago.
How do you put up with me?
I knew that question was gonna happen. So he's been like this ever since I met him. We're kind of the same people, but I'm not as loud as him, I guess you would say. But when you get us together with our friends, we're the exact same.
She twerks better than me.
The whole ride-along crew could tell you that.
She twerks better than me. Do you dance like me?
I danced for 16 years, believe it or not. But I did proper dancing. I didn't do...
She did this stuff.
The nasty dancing.
She did this.
I did tap, ballet, jazz, hip-hop for 16 years.
Spirit fingers.
And I did show choir for 4 years. And we won nationals every year. We were pretty good.
Yeah. This battle tastes... Proper dancing. Why would you call that proper dancing?
Your dancing is not proper. You hump chairs.
Oh my God, why would you call me out? No one knows that.
If you come to our house, we have a broken bar stool, and it's so funny because everyone who comes over here knows that that stool is broken because of him. And how do I put up with them like that? Because that's how I met him. That's all I know.
Just out here humping chairs at the bar when she met me. Pretty much used to it by now. Okay, that question's been asked like three times.
What is it like being married to a police officer? I'm not gonna lie, it's not easy. It's not easy at all. It's hard, but...
But there's handcuffs.
No.
The fluffy ones.
It's not easy. You just have to become like really close. You have to have a good support system. If you don't have kids or if you do have kids, being friends with those other police wives is so important. That you two, you know, you girls get together when the guys are working, or even if it's a different department, you girls are so close. I am so close with all police wives. Those are my best friends. So just having a good support system.
Somebody got muted in here. Probably talking nasty. You up in here nasty.
Who's your favorite of the other writers?
Do you want to answer that question?
I love them all. They're all so different. Okay, guys. I have to tell you about the first time I met them, which was Ride Along 1. Kevin Lawson came and spent the night with us the first night before anyone else came. And Charlie and I had put the kids to bed. He didn't show up till like 10 o'clock at night. But Charlie and I were like, oh my God, this guy is so amazing. And the next morning, all of them came over. And they all came over in a big bunch. And I was just like, they're all so different. Short, tall, farmer, not farmer, police officer, you know, all of them. And it's just... It's so crazy because I was probably the first wife to like, or the first person to watch it all come together, those group of guys. And it was just so amazing how well they clicked together. Like, It was insane. And I had the time of my life with them. And it was a blast.
Good time.
So if you haven't seen their show, you should go to it.
That's right. If you haven't... Yeah, that's right. We should advertise that real quick. Yeah. If you haven't been to one of our shows yet, if you missed Knoxville or Sevierville or Sevierville, what's Sevierville?
I wasn't there. I don't know.
Then you should come April 22nd to... South Carolina, Columbia, South Carolina, or April 23rd to Brunswick, Georgia. Ticket links are in my bio, May 14th for Fort Wayne.
I heard it was really funny, and the other wives were sending me videos.
We've been married for nine years.
9 in June.
9 years.
What's your favorite thing about each other?
Oh, you can say my booty.
No.
She does. She likes it.
I would say that not every day is the same. He's always different every day. And he's so fun.
Babe, they call that multiple personalities disorder.
What's your favorite thing about me?
I can't even name just one. I just love everything about you.
Oh, my God.
I can't even name just one. Like, she's nice. She's a nice lady. She's a nice lady. And she got
seriously, what is your favorite thing about me?
Your personality. You're fine. You put up with me. That's my favorite thing about you is the fact that you put up with me.
There you go. Oh, McCordsville.
Oh, McCordsville, what's up? We met in college through friends. A guy I played baseball with was my college roommate. And his wife now and Christine were both friends.
She was actually my assistant when I first started hiring assistants. I know, I don't know how I became blonde. It just kind of creeped out, especially when we were in Florida.
Did it get that blonde in Florida?
Look at it. It's so blonde.
It's very blonde.
Do you like it?
Do I?
Yeah.
Yes, I like it.
Are you lying?
Yes, it's like a stranger. You know, like what a stranger. Like, I had this one wife before we went to Florida.
Bad.
I had this one wife before we went to Florida, and we got back from Florida, and now I have a new wife. And that's how we switch it up so much.
Ew.
Is we die, like, whenever we get tired of, like, the one, whenever I get tired of my one wife, I have her dye her hair, and then I have another wife. And then whenever she gets tired of me.
What, you get red hair or gray hair?
Yeah, she she dyes my facial hair. How did I propose?
Oh, you need to tell that story.
You tell the story.
No, you need to. It's long.
You tell the story.
It's so long.
Oh my gosh.
It's long. Are you guys ready? It's long. It was very dramatic.
So, I hired the entire Colts football team.
No, he didn't.
You tell the story.
All right, so... Him and his best friend and I lived in a condo together, and he told me, hey, I went out to lunch with my girlfriends, and he was like, hey, you need to be ready by a certain time. There's an envelope on the kitchen table. I'm going out for beers. So I come home hanging out with my girlfriends, and I open up this envelope, and it says, be ready by, 5:36, and open up this envelope when you get into your ride. So I put on this dress. He told me to buy a cute little dress, whatever, summer dress. So I did, and you had to buzz into her condo to ring her doorbell. And so I hear a buzz, and they were like, hi, is this Christine? And I said, yes. And they were like, can you come downstairs? So I grabbed my stuff, and I went downstairs. There was a stretch limo. And so I get into the limo, and I open up the envelope, and it says...
I'll be back in an hour when the story's over.
It was a gift card to go get my nails done at my favorite place. And so the limo driver took me there. He knew where he was going. So I go get my nails done. They're like all hee hee hee. Like they knew what was happening. And I literally, way over my head. I had no idea. And so I get my nails done. I get the quickest thing because I just wanted to get the heck out of there. And I get back into the limo and they're taking all these ways downtown, and I'm very familiar with downtown, and they were taking weird ways, whatever. And so we pull up to Roost Chris?
I think so.
Roost Chris, which is a very nice restaurant. And I walk in and the hostess takes me straight back to Charlie, and here he is with dinner. And I thought we were just celebrating our anniversary or my birthday, something. So we're there, we eat dinner, And then he walks me out, takes my hand. He's like, hey, my mom's going to come pick us up. I'm like, oh, okay, that's cool.
That's pretty cool.
Then a horse and buggy carriage ride showed up. And so we got in that. We went downtown. It was super cute. And then we pulled up to the Hilton Hotel downtown Indy.
Danny might as well tell them what room number we was in. This story's so long.
I walk into the hotel room and there were candles and roses everywhere and it said, I love you, with an arrow pointing down. And I was like, what? And he was down on one knee and he asked me to marry him.
I say, hey, this is what I said. I was down on one knee. It looked like this. I said, do you want this for the rest of your life?
But guys, I didn't have it. I didn't go shopping for this ring. He did really good. He got it from Jared.
It's fake. Don't tell her.
He did good.
It's fake. Don't tell her.
So then he had a bunch of friends out, and then we met up with them, and And then so our reception was there, and it was amazing.
I was like, you want to see this every morning when you wake up. Me and nothing but a gold Speedo and a cigar.
Hey, you have that gold Speedo.
I do have a gold Speedo, you're very right. Oh, I gotta turn the music. Oh, whatever.
Somebody said music's copyright or something.
Copyright?
I don't know, we'll turn it down. Whatever. I don't have to be so loud at that point in time. I don't know if we should give marriage advice just because, like,
you're scrolling over the same questions.
I know. It's not like we're, like, perfect all the time. We have our own stuff, too, so. We're just like a normal married couple.
Yeah.
Our kids are not asleep. Nope. Yeah. Are you taking? Oh my god. I'm trying to find one.
Who is more competitive? There you go.
That's a good one.
Is it you or is it me?
It's probably you, but you don't beat me in nothing, though.
Yeah, but, like, I'm competitive in my own things, but you are very competitive with your things.
Right, but when we have competitions, she don't beat me in nothing.
Bowling.
You beat me in bowling. You beat me in bowling, because I got a 9.5 fingers, so it's hard for me to hold the bowling ball. That's the only reason she beat me.
I'm really good at bowling.
You throw gutter balls. I let you win because
we
had that bet and you knew what that bet was and I let you win so I could get that prize. So yeah, we're both pretty competitive.
You like scroll to the bottom.
Sorry, getting there.
All right, stop.
Have I eaten your reduced fat peanut butter? No.
It's so. That's a good one.
You pick them then.
So do people from TikTok come up to you guys in public? They don't come up to me. So it started happening, Halloween last year?
Yeah, probably.
Yeah. So we went to the Halloween store and, I gave the girl my credit card because we were buying costumes for us and the kids. And she looks at my car and she goes, oh my God. She's like, is that Officer Kingery? And I'm like, oh. And it happened a couple times before, but when we were leaving for Florida, the guy at security, he gave him his ID and he goes, I love your TikToks. It happens all the time now.
Wake up.
It's funny. Who's more jealous? Nobody. We're not jealous.
No. I told you, and that's the thing, like, she's been putting up with my dancing for like 12 years now.
Yeah, none of this like on the chair stuff or his dancing. He's talented.
It's just dancing at the end of the day. I get that question all the time. Like, what does your wife think about your dancing? Like, at the end of the day, it's just dancing. Like, I'm not taking my clothes off. I've never done a shirtless TikTok. I've never...
Can you please play Luke Bryan? Have you told them about my obsession with Luke Bryan?
No, you tell them. She got a Luke Bryan pillow.
I do.
Guy looks like Beavis.
Can you go get it? Luke Bryan.
Where's it at?
In my closet. On my mantle. I am obsessed with Luke Bryan. Like, I have been wanting, I've been asking him, I've had this crush on him for so many years. Charlie thinks it's hilarious because he thinks he's so ugly. and I could have a crush on anybody, and I pick Luke Bryan. But I love him, and I would love to go to that Crash My Playa little big concert that he puts on in Mexico, but he won't go. I need people to go with me. I love Luke Bryan. He makes fun of his skinny jeans, and he wears skinny jeans. But my girlfriend, when I was sick over the summer, she gave me this for my birthday.
I do not make fun of the skinny jeans. I make fun of his music. He's got terrible music.
No, he has good music.
Look at this. Look at it. Looks like looks like Squidward.
I love him.
Oh my God, this guy's ridiculous.
Yes! Look at him, he's so cute! See, don't we make a cute couple?
Oh my God. Freaking Luke Bryan shrine.
Okay, if you had a hall pass, tell him your hall pass.
Mila Kunis.
He loves Mila Kunis.
But Mila Kunis is attractive. Luke Bryan ain't attractive.
She looks like an alien.
Alright, we're not getting into this.
She looks like an alien. Charlie getting jelly.
I'm not getting jealous of that guy. That guy's awful.
Gerard Butler would be my second pick. Who is more high maintenance? Oh, this is good. Not me.
Bullshit.
No, guys.
Oh, my God. No, you're about to tell some secrets. No,
this is good.
This ain't true.
Charlie. Oh, this is good. So, like, even on this Florida trip the past last week or whatever, and even when Udi's here, like, or Scales, they're like, God, why is Charlie taking so long to get ready? I'm like, dude, it takes him an hour to take a shower, lotion up. He has this lotion routine. He has
to lotion. I got dry skin. I'm scaly. I got dry skin, okay? It's ashy. Get off my back.
No, no. He's so high maintenance. It's him.
I do not. It's not me.
It takes him forever to get ready.
I can't believe you just made made fun of me for having dry skin. How dare you?
You don't have dry skin.
There are dry-skinned people all over the world, and you just made, like, there's probably dry-skinned people in this live right now, and you're just talking that type of trash.
I'm not, but it takes you an hour. It takes you an hour to get ready.
I don't know why, because it don't take very long to wash these small body parts, so.
Not the booty.
I think we need some embarrassing Charlie stories.
I don't have any. Oh, what about like your 21st birthday when Steak and Chick bathroom? Is that a good one?
It's a pretty good one. You tell it.
No, you tell it.
I'm not going to tell an embarrassing story on myself. Okay, so the night, all right, so I meet Christine on my 21st birthday, whatever.
And he was so like, wow.
She yelled at me from across the bar for one.
And I did not. Screaming and yelling at me. He came up to me.
White trash, mother. And so I went to Steak and Shake that night with some buddies afterwards. That was my 21st birthday. I was pretty intoxicated at that point in time. And so I had snuck to the bathroom. While they were eating their cheese fries and everything. And I went to the bathroom, and about 30 minutes had passed, and they couldn't find me, so they come into the Steak and Shake bathroom. And apparently I thought that was my bedroom, because I had his butt naked on the bathroom floor.
Hugging the toilet,
and my clothes were folded in the stall right next to me. So apparently I thought I was at home.
And I still married him. Or I still dated him for 3 years and then married him.
See, so she's been dealing with this for 12 years. So.
Yes. Oh, God, that sounds like so long.
Well, it is what it is. Oh, no, we gotta go to the bottom.
You know you married Tatum's double, right?
Oh, yeah, you like that, huh?
No.
Huh? How you like them apples?
No.
Channing Tatum don't want the smoke in the dance off.
Do either of your kids take after Charlie? My daughter. My daughter has been watching him make TikToks, and now she will prop up my phone, start the video, and then she'll just do her little dances.
This is my daughter. Like, she'll... So, we find videos on my wife's phone all the time. And it's like this. She's like this. She's like...
She is. But she's like... The words she said, I love Mom. She's my angel. We're best friends. It's so cute. So, yeah. Our daughter, definitely. My son takes after me. I hope it returns soon.
Hold on, it says unstable connection. Are we back? Maybe. A good connection. I think we froze there for a second.
Have you heard anything about Life, Peter?
No, I think it'll be back some... Oh, who knows nowadays? Who knows? I don't know. Yeah. Who knows when it's going to come back?
I miss it. All our friends and family miss it so much. It was fun to watch on a Friday and Saturday night. Who is the pushover with the kids?
Huh? You want to go ahead and answer this one?
I'm the pushover with the kids. But I think it's because I'm with them the most. So he's a really good discipliner. I'm with the kids every single night. He leaves to go to work.
I established that very early on in age.
He did.
That I don't even have to discipline my kids anymore. I just look at them. Like, when I look at them, they know what's up. They stop doing what they're doing.
But it's good to have a parent that's like that. But the kids, yeah, they'll run right over me.
Do we have any matching tattoos?
I think this is a good one.
Then click it.
I got an answer for this. What do you think about other women fangirling? I get this question a lot by close friends. Like, how do you read the comments? Like, are you serious? Like, I would go angry. Come to my house, live with him for 24 hours, then still do it. Come on! Come live with him!
Are you trying to say that no one would be... put up with my ass?
Correct.
You're full of shit. I got so many funny stories on Christine.
Go for it. Tell them one.
I mean, I can't even think of them. It should be out this weekend or the beginning of next week. You want to tell? It's pretty good, isn't it?
Yeah, I just got my first sweatshirt and it's super cute. It's so cute. I love it. I can't wait to wear it. He won't let me wear it to the gym, which I wanted to wear it, but...
You can wear it after we launch it. But, yeah, we got stuff for everybody. Even if you're not a military first responder...
No.
Even if you're not a military first responder, anything like that, if you're just a supporter or whoever or anything like that, we have stuff for everybody. Do y'all have matching tattoos? Yes. No. So...
I want to tell the story about my tattoo.
Okay.
So I never thought I would have a tattoo. So what, was it a year of us dating?
Well.
Charlie goes, I think it would be really hot if you would get like a tattoo on the back of your neck.
Or like on the top of your back.
You said the top.
I really said your butt cheek if you want to tell people the truth.
And I was like, oh my God. So this guy, whatever, I'll get a tattoo. I regret, it's a cross. It's very,
don't even look bad.
It's very nice.
Show everybody.
No. But I'm not a tattoo person.
It's a doolally on her spine. She got a doolally directly on her spine.
No, I don't, but I just wish I never did it. But I did it for him. Because I was in love.
did you hear how she said was? I was. I was in love. That's why you bought fat, reduced fat peanut butter. Like, shit tastes like carbs.
Hey, I'm
trying
to tell you something.
Tastes like the lid. Oh, God, really?
No.
Stuff tastes like the lid.
How long have you been a police officer?
Pop it, guess 8. What's up? How long have I been a police officer? I've been in law enforcement for 10 years now. I'll tell you what, I've been in law enforcement for 10 years. And this last year alone feels like the longest 10 years ever. I mean, it feels like the longest year ever. But I still love it. Get back in there. This is your life. This ain't my life. People don't want to see me. They want to see you.
Your guys' comments are so sweet.
We have 2 kids.
They're handfuls. You're going through the same ones.
I'm at the bottom. You scroll and pick one. People can still see you, too, when you're making that silly face like that. Like, you making that face?
How many tattoos do you have? I don't even keep count.
I don't know. That's such a crazy question because, like, do you count my entire sleeve as one because it's multiple parts? So I got 2 sleeves. I got a chest hat. I got a back. I'm doing my entire back.
Who is the most stubborn? Oh.
You.
No.
How did... How... Whatever.
She asked, who is the most stubborn?
You are.
It's probably both. We're both pretty stubborn.
How did I get involved with Live PD? Live PD came to our police department, wanted to ride along with our police department. Our chief and everybody said yes, and then they just asked volunteers who wanted to do it. Sorry, we gotta get to the bottom of this so we can actually see some questions.
Ask me some wedding questions.
Yeah, talk about your talk about your wedding.
Ask me anything. I got some stories.
How big of an event have you planned?
How big? Actually, I'm getting ready to do my biggest wedding, which is 370. Hopefully, if COVID lets us do that. That's probably my biggest.
Yeah.
But, I mean, with the parade, like, that was thousands and thousands of people. But I would say, wedding-wise, any famous weddings? I haven't done a famous one. I did do... The girl that was his producer at Live PD and the cameraman, they were engaged, and I got to do their wedding, which is great.
You have someone with Andrew Luck.
What's the worst? Well, Andrew Luck like came into Family Pictures. Hold on. I wanted to go to this. What is the worst thing that's ever happened? What has been the most shocking wedding moment? So, guys, how many years ago was it? Had a person die at a cocktail reception or cocktail hour before the bride and groom even got there. And it was awful, but it was at a venue where we could, you know, he had a heart attack and I actually knew him because I just planned his daughter's wedding. So they moved everybody upstairs. I took a bunch of alcohol, put it outside, and I created like a mini cocktail party for the bride and groom when they showed up with the bridal party. And that was like October. I can't even tell you what year, but that was the most shocking thing. It was awful.
You know you a good wedding planner if you got somebody die and you still get a good review.
Well,
like, you still got a good review.
No. The largest wedding party is probably like 26, which is crazy.
13 each?
It's awful. People are going smaller though. Runaway bride or grooms. I have never had that. I have never had a runaway bride or groom.
She about had one at her own wedding.
No, I did not.
I was about to beat feet out of there. She told me. Yes, she did. She told me right before the wedding that as soon as we elope, I'm not allowed to leave the house.
And I had to be handcuffed to the bed. I don't wish it, but I think that... I want to write a book one day, okay? I have so many stories... And one of the Live PD producers was like, just start journalizing everything that you have done. Each wedding, just go through and just journalize and then just give it to someone to write the book. But I would have to totally ghost write that book because I don't want to call out my people.
Are you reading questions off there or you want the Q&A?
Don't care.
You read any?
Ooh. I don't have any theme. So... My May wedding is probably like my first themed wedding and it's on May 4th. So May the 4th be with you. They're not doing anything with Star Wars. They just got engaged. What is that ride in Disney World? The
Thunder from Down Under.
No. Oh. There's like a Star Wars. I forget. The Millennium Falcon or something. But they got engaged in front of there, so they wanted to get married on May the 4th be with you, which is a Tuesday, which is wonderful. Have you ever had a bridezilla? Yes. 90% of my weddings are bridezillas, but I love them. I have a type A bride and I have a type B bride, and I love both. Because type A is like, hey, I've gotten all this done, execute it. And then my type B bride is like, hey, I don't know what to do. Do everything for me. And I love those kinds of weddings too.
She got them all.
How old are your babies? They're getting ready to turn 5 and 8. Most expensive wedding? Okay, so the average cost of a wedding changes within the state. In Indiana right now, the average cost of a wedding is $30,000 to $35,000, which is absolutely nuts. But I can work with any budget.
And she travels.
And I travel.
So she can travel any state and be your wedding planner, and I can be her plus one.
And he's the assistant.
And I will be the assistant, and I will be the plus one, and I'm ready to dance. So get this party started and book her. But tell them your address. Tell them your website again. What's your website?
www.
There you go. You got to put the W.
ChristineKingeryEvents.com.
Christine with a C.
But hey, guys, we should, I'm telling you, I think we should both write a book together because we have some amazing stories.
It's called The Wedding Planner and the Pig. Look at this pig over here.
You're not a pig.
Just the pig.
Do you do baby showers? So, yeah.
Just, my son just walked. My son just walked by and snorted at me.
So, again, I'm rolling out a new business that we do anything, all the events. I just did a huge 50th birthday party at a really fancy smancy country club in northern Indiana, and it was so much fun. And so I'm, again, do any kind of events.
You see
any tips for becoming an event planner? So if you're wanting to be...
Just the tip. just the tip.
So I get this question a lot, and I get a lot of emails about people that want to just start out doing weddings or events. I would say, you know, get certified. There's a lot of programs out there that can help you get certified. But then experience. Experience is everything. Like, after 9 years, I'm still learning from all my weddings. I literally learn something new every day, every wedding. Every wedding is so different. That's why I love my job, and I think that's why he loves his job, is because every day is different. So it's very exciting.
Yep, one day everything could be just fine, and all of a sudden I got poop being thrown at me by some arrestee throwing turds. Yeah, imagine working a job for $50,000 a year and dudes be throwing turds at you. Imagine
Have
that.
Have you ever gotten turds?
Oh, yeah, I'd be throwing turds all the time.
So he never tells me stories. I always hear stories. If he's telling them to our friends, will never come home and tell me anything.
You know you work a job you love when you, like, respond to calls with people covered in doo-doo. I'd be so mad. Are we going to Woodtalk? Maybe.
I don't know.
I will be there, yes. I don't know if she will be.
TBD.
I will be there. But yeah, if you haven't got your Woodtalk tickets, www.wudtok.com. Woodtalk. Go check it out. What's your worst fear?
Ooh.
The good one.
What is your worst fear? He hates flying. When there's a little turbulence,
I'm like, oh shit!
Are we okay? Then Audra's over there.
I did that. Like, okay, because I don't care what anybody says. You guys are all so full of it. Anybody who says they like flying is full of shit.
Planes are made to deal with turbulence. Turbulence is supposed to happen.
I don't care. I'm 900,000 feet in the air on a metal box. And dudes be farting within 3 seats of me, smelling up the whole thing. Who likes flying? I can't even get a drink on a flight right now. I can drink water, but I can't drink alcohol on a flight right now because that apparently doesn't kill COVID. Who the hell likes flying? Oh, look at all these people. I love flying. I love flying. I hate
to fly. He hates it. My daughter loves it. She puts up her hands. Whee!
I've flown so much, though, but it doesn't get, like, I don't enjoy it.
Someone just said suggestions on boy names. Okay, so I told Charlie this when we were in Florida. I love the name. I said if you have a boy, right now, if you're pregnant and you had a boy, the name Diesel is super cute.
It depends on what your last name was.
So, like, Diesel Kingery? It's cute.
Yeah, but we're not having no more kids unless you want to have another kid. Then I got to go in.
Someone just asked. I think Diesel sounds cute.
But if you want to have a Diesel, I got to go in and I got to get the reverse snippage. And then I got to get the reset snippage. I'll be over here looking like Frankensack.
I don't want that.
Be all scarred up. Diesel is a dog's name. Thank you. Diesel is a dog's name. I like that name. Look at all these people.
Yes.
Look at all these people be co-signing for you.
Oh, what? Yes, we do still keep in touch with our friend whose husband passed away. They live in Connecticut, so she's actually going to come up and meet us with her best friend and visit with us and explore Maine with us. So yes, we're still very close with her.
Yeah, we're still close.
And we love her so much.
I don't want to go into would you help plan a party for someone graduating the police academy?
Yes, I would. Where are you at? Where do you live?
Well, you're not going to be.
I'm from Connecticut.
It's going to be tough for you to see again.
Oh, so the thing I noticed about Connecticut when we went is because we met so many of our friends there. They have such a, like, hard accent, and they think we're, like, from Kentucky, which is so funny. But some of them have, like, hard accents and some don't. It's so funny. I know, I wish I could join more ride-alongs, but my job just takes me away from that.
Yeah, she works a lot of weekends and stuff, and that's usually when we have the ride-along, so it's kind of tough for her.
I have a TikTok, but I'm awful at doing it. So I just hired my assistant to take over my social media, and TikTok is on our list.
Yeah, she has a TikTok. If you go to my, if you go to Christine Kingery Events on TikTok, or but she doesn't really post on there.
Go to Instagram.
Yeah, if you want to follow her, go to Instagram, Christine Kingery Events on Instagram. You can follow her there. And you can reach out there or on her website if you want her to plan.
Yeah, I just got my website redone too, and it's really cool. What was that? What's your favorite place in Connecticut? Where did we go?
I can't. Somebody asked me that the other day when at the show asked me what place in Connecticut we went to, and I couldn't.
What brand is your wig? This ain't a wig. This is my hair.
See, I told you people be coming in here talking that hella shit.
This is my hair. Guys, you should have seen it a couple months ago. It was like all the way down here.
People be coming here just like making up dumb shit.
Like, I don't have a wig.
What brand is your wig?
I do not have a wig. This is my real hair.
It's really not her real hair. She can actually take that out.
Oh, look at all these Connecticut people. I love it.
What brand is your wig? Ooh, shit.
I don't. Where are you originally from? South side of Indianapolis. Oh, probation officer here. Got your six. I love it.
Mighty nice wig you have there. It's a mighty nice wig.
Nashville. I want to go back. Luke Bryan is a married man. Yes, he is. But it's okay.
People can crush on people.
People crush on my husband. It's just fine.
Am I going to get some more ink? Yes. If it was up to me, I'd be covered. Other than my face and neck, but I'd be covered everywhere else. Not saying if you got face and neck tats, that's bad, but I'm just saying for me, I would be anywhere.
Foxwoods. We were close to Foxwoods Casino. Someone just said that. We were like 20 minutes from there, if that means anything. Have you told them where your family is from in Kentucky?
Yep. Hazard, Kentucky. Everybody knows that, though. They asked you, what's the smallest venue you've done?
The smallest venue? Ew. Oh, I don't know. I've never been asked that before. I don't know.
Yo, Kingery's love you. Appreciate that. Thank you. Christine, do you have any tattoos? Yeah, she has one on her back.
I have one.
The ride-along tattoo is still happening. So Georgia, Udi, and I have to get it. And we are in talks with... I mean, it's so difficult getting everybody together for the same weekend right now.
Where are you getting the tattoos?
I'm getting it on my leg. I'm getting it from John Dump. So we got to schedule the weekend from John Dump to get the tattoo. Still happening. I don't make bets like that and not follow through with it.
No. I was actually scared about that.
About to get the
vegan. I didn't want the vegan lady on his leg going, and I thought the guys would do that to me, and I was like, no, I don't want to see that.
I told
that's
her straight
up. Turn off.
I was like, I'm gonna get that vegan lady right by my doolally. That's what.
Is she still on TikTok?
That's what Udi says. What's up?
Is she the vegan?
No,
lady
she got kicked off there. She go.
She crazy.
Sit on a cactus elsewhere. I had anxiety.
Aw, people are so sweet on here.
Yeah, so We do still have this. Somebody asked another question about this. Don't ever buy this. Don't ever buy this.
It's fine. What is the most embarrassing? That question's been asked a couple times. What is the most embarrassing thing you've done at your job? Maybe I've gotten on the dance floor before I left. I don't know.
Oh, you?
I don't know.
She shit her pants one day at work.
No, I did not.
Yes, she did. At her old job, she shit her pants.
Oh my God, I did not. This is such a bull lie. This is a lie.
Okay, let me. Okay, no, so, okay, no, so she. Hey, I'm gonna tell it though. We want to tell embarrassing stories right now. We want to tell embarrassing stories, okay? She shit her pants at her old job, 100%.
I know.
I believe it 100%. She shit her pants at her old job, okay? So she comes home, she has to leave work early, and she's like devastated. Look at her. She's getting all mad at me right now. She says to me, she was like, I went into the stall to use the bathroom, and I sat in shit.
Yes.
Tell that part of the story. You tell the story.
So I went to the bathroom, whatever, went pee, and I sat in poop, and I walked out, and I told my boss, my old boss, and which those two are like one of my best friends. And I was like, guys, come in this room right now with me. And they were like, God, what does that smell? And I was like, guys, I just did this. Like, what just happened? And they were all like, ew. And I was like, literally, I think someone, it was an older lady who
went, don't make it up,
went on the toilet seat.
Okay, so
and
I'm gonna...
I sat in it. So I went home, wiped my booty.
I hope you showered. Did you shower?
Yes,
you can't
I showered.
Setting other people's dookie in
and
that
I had
shower.
An event to plan, so I had to be back at the law firm. So I went back to the law firm.
Okay, let me paint the scene for
he
you.
Thinks I
you
shit
okay?
Her pants. I
she
did
shit.
Not.
She 100% shit herself.
No, I did not.
Let
I
me would... paint. Okay, let me paint the picture here. Okay, who does this? All right, say okay. I'm walking into a stall right now. Okay, I open the stall door. And then I just back my ass up like this and sit down. You didn't look at the toilet before you sat down.
Who sits
and shit? Who sits and shit?
I did.
You, how do you not look at the toilet but in a public bathroom?
That was like 10 years ago.
So you shit, you're finally admitting you shit yourself.
No, I'm not admitting it. I will never admit that.
She shit herself, 100%.
I don't. I guess I was just being lazy that day. I don't.
You were being lazy, so you just wanted
to... I just
to,
sat.
You just shit.
No!
It's fine.
I don't look. I guess I was... Now I look.
Well, I'd hope so. Who doesn't look before sitting at a public restroom? That's like sitting at a porta-potty.
Everyone's saying they look at it. Now I do. 10 years later.
That's like sitting in a porta-potty without looking.
Does Officer Kinger know any canine handlers? Yes, one of our good friends is a canine handler.
I have several.
I absolutely love him.
I have several on my department.
Oh, someone starts FTO soon. I start FTO in 3 weeks. Any tips?
Yeah, just listen to whoever your FTO is. I mean, just learn from them. Sometimes people come in thinking they know everything or... back talking their FTOs, just do what he tells you, learn from him. If you want to do it a different way later, then that's something that you can do, but just
and then you ask about your wife too, so tell her just become friends with the other wives. It's the best thing ever because you guys all support each other. Do we like to cook? He cooks some mean chicken.
I'll be cooking up the chickens. Christine,
I make some good biscuits and gravy.
She does. A little more salt in there would be good, but the biscuits and gravy.
I'll kill you. How do you keep the spark alive in your marriage? This is a good question.
So every Tuesday night she has me swing from the fan in our bedroom. So there's a bedroom. We have a bedroom fan that spins on the ceiling, and she makes me get up there and spin around, and that really.
I say we try, even if it's on a Tuesday, Wednesday, Thursday when he's off work. Those 3 days are his weekend, and then I try and make them mine. We do date nights all the time, whether it just be us or whether it be friends. We always make time for each other, and we always make sure we have a good time because we have, again, we have a good support system. So,
true story. Comedic Cody in here. What's up? What's up, Cody?
Hi, Cody.
What are you guys doing over there?
get to meet him? No.
No, you haven't.
I haven't met him yet.
How about some love for your dispatchers during National Dispatcher Week?
Woo!
Shout out to the dispatchers. Not given near the credit you deserve. You. Thank you for the dispatchers. Y'all deserve some big credit. Keeping us safe, looking out for us.
Aw, thank you. You guys are so cute. I've been to Wisconsin before.
Frankie! Damn it, Frankie!
Hold on, someone had a good question. How do you feel about the hate that law enforcement is getting? It sucks. But you just have to, you know, support them. Be here. Be their support system. So why do you like the Bengals? So Charlie's family is from Hazard, Kentucky. He hates everything Indiana, which makes it really difficult for our son because my son loves anything NFL, MLB, whatever. So he's really confused on who to like. So I love the Colts. He loves the Bengals. So we fight about this all the time. I do like Kentucky Wildcats, though.
We support the blue. Thank you.
Who day?
No. That's right. That's right. Big Blue Nation. Look at that.
No.
You said you like Kentucky.
Colts. No.
We're talking about Kentucky. Big Blue Nation.
Oh, I thought they were talking about... No, there's a lot of Bengals, though. Sorry, I was confusing it.
Nurse here.
What's
up?
What is Charlie's most hated food?
Ooh.
What is your most hated food?
Mushrooms.
Oh, yeah. I don't like mushrooms either.
I don't do mushrooms. I don't eat onions. I don't eat tomatoes.
Oh, see, I like none of that
shit. I don't like none of that shit. Took my son to a steak dinner tonight.
Hmm.
Smashing some steaks.
Landon asked him. He was like, Dad, take me to a steak dinner. So we took them. Super cute.
Somebody said fat-free peanut butter. Yeah, so my new most favorite hated food is fat-free peanut butter. Favorite fast food. I think we both have the same one on this one, right? Since how you order $120 of it every time you've been drinking.
Oh, Taco Bell.
Taco Bell, no.
We love Taco Bell. Aw, you guys are nice.
I'll try to check out your duet when I get off here.
Fried pickles. Who said yuck fried pickles? Onions, yuck, pickles, yuck, but fried pickles. Oh, okay.
Fried pickles are good. Pickles are good. I love pickles.
So my son doesn't like pickles, so we're like, you're not a king or anything, because we love pickles. Taco Bell is my favorite, yes.
We like dill pickles, not that bread and butter shit.
Oh, yeah. In Florida, we got...
That
what
bread
did
and
we,
butter.
Yeah, they ordered sandwiches, and they got... what looked like dill pickles, but Charlie bit into it. He's like, it's bread and butter. Oops.
Udi in the house. Udi what's up?
House. Lucifer.
Hey, Udi, why don't you request to come into this live? You or Cody. Why don't you or Cody come in here and request we'll go dual live right now, huh? You got that option? I got that option. Why don't you request to come in here, Udi with the booty? Udi with the fat ass booty. Oh,
right there's Georgia.
Georgia.
Hey, Georgia.
We got the whole gang in here now. Yeah, you guys better come to our show. If you're not coming to our show April 22nd or April 23rd, April 22nd in Columbia, South Carolina, Brunswick, Georgia, April 23rd, come check us out. Ticket links in all of our bios, or you can go to ticketbud.com, type in content violation. Mm-hmm. Let's go.
Why is your font so big on your text messages? Are you getting old?
I am getting old. My contacts are getting worse.
Oh, Lord. He's only... How old are you? 33?
32.
No, 32. I'm going to be 34.
You're a cougar. You're Robin, Robin the Cradle.
By a year.
Robin the Cradle.
Half, whatever. A year and a half. Does Indiana have sweet tea? Ask Georgia.
Hey, Georgia, does Indiana have sweet tea, bro? Hey, that's your question to answer, Georgia.
Georgia was so mad because we don't have good sweet tea. And we were like, just go, you know, get the sweet tea and just, or just get tea and add Splenda to it. And he's like, no, no.
All right, so tell them again about your new business coming out, because there's probably a lot of new people in here.
New website, business, the Kingery Group. It's going to be, so I own my own wedding planning business, and I'm starting out another business, the Kingery Group, and it's for event, travel, and home design. So we will be doing anything event-wise. So birthday parties, bridal parties, you know, anything.
So go to Google and type in www.thekingerygroup.com.
Kingerydesigngroup.com.
Kingerydesigngroup.com. Or just go
and
to
he's
Google.
A part of it a little bit.
There is a security aspect of it. So.
Yeah, he's going to hire some security officers for my events.
Not hiring them. Like, people have to hire you.
Yeah.
So if you want event security or anything like that and you're in the Indianapolis area, let us know.
Let us know. And then travel, I've been studying to become certified as a travel agent. I know you don't have to, but I feel like I need to, you know, get my experience and booking vacations and booking my clients' honeymoons and everything. I'm in week 12 of 19.
Who's that? Oh, Udi with a booty. What's up, buddy?
What up? What's up, Goofy? You're the damn devil. Look who I found. Look who I found.
I'm not the devil. Come on. Why are you telling me we're the devil?
What's up, guys?
Oh, hey.
What's going on?
Oh, look at the lives now. just sitting here talking to the most favorite members of the ride-along crew, since you guys always get together at TR's house and don't invite anybody.
That's not true. You're always
invited,
welcome.
Dude. You can always.
Yeah, it costs
the difference
me,
is we're 3 hours apart. And you're like 12 hours
me,
out there.
$40 to come to TR. It cost me $1,000 to come to your house.
That's a good point.
Well, yeah, and you came, didn't you?
I did. And I appreciate you.
Also, it's just like way more stuff to do at my house all the time, always.
Yeah, and then I don't have to deal with Lucifer.
Yeah.
That's yeah, true. Like touch cow wieners.
Hey, tell everybody why you call me Lucifer.
Because you're the devil.
Why? I'm a nice lady. Hey, Katie, I've never met you.
Hi, guys.
Nice to meet you.
Nice. What's up, Jode?
Well, okay. Yeah, so good to see you guys.
Look at the hype.
What's up, Cody?
It's like my son here. Buddy. It's like my son.
Love you too, buddy. Hope you guys are doing good.
Well, it's nice to meet you.
Nice to meet you as well. Whose lab is this?
I'm nicer than him.
It's nice to meet. First of all, kick rock. Why is it so? It's nice to. Oh, don't get these people.
I'm not a mean person.
Hey, Udi, I got
very nice to meet you.
Udi and Cody, I got somebody who wants to say hi.
Look, Landon's the same height.
What's up,
buddy? What's up, buddy?
Who does he look like?
You gotta turn it off if you showed your kids.
Who's he? Looks like his daddy.
No, he looks like me.
No, he doesn't. He looks like his daddy.
Sit right there.
Oh, you want to see? Oh, you want to see Brick McNasty?
Okay. Hi.
Oh,
I'm Brick. Nasty.
Hello.
There's
how are you?
I know,
there's
right?
There's Nasty Brit.
Brittany McNasty.
Lies.
Right.
I don't know why they say these things.
Oh, Brittany McNasty. Sorry.
They're so full of it.
Christine,
everyone tells me that you and I would get along so well.
Probably.
Awesome.
Oh, you both got big duck trucks.
Really?
Yeah. It's nice. It's a nice feature.
I don't have a big duck.
They both got shitty attitudes.
Oh, Lord. I am a ball of social.
The only difference between Brittany is she treats TR so well. Christine is so mean to Charlie. And, like, it breaks my heart.
See, wow. Now you're getting called out right now.
Wow.
That's why I call her Lucifer, because every time really? I go to Charlie, like, this man rubs her feet, brings her flowers, and she is so mean to him. Like, I don't understand it.
He rubs my feet?
Now you know you're lying, because you know I don't like feet. Feet are nasty. Nobody's feet.
Pull it up, crap. Nah, put it on you, man. This is y'all's thing.
Oh, wow.
What are y'all talking about in y'all's life?
Well, people are saying that Landon looks like me, which is really cute. Audra
has.
I think he looks like me.
Audra has every bit of your attitude.
Huh?
Audra has every bit of your attitude.
I think Landon looks like a baby Keener. I think he looks a little bit like Keener.
No, he does. Landon is his daddy made over.
Yeah, I would agree with that. I see is Charlie when I see Landon.
He used to be my twin.
I haven't seen him.
Hey, she wants to see Landon. She wants to see Landon.
Come here.
She wants to see Landon.
Landon, come here. Take your hat off. Your kids come here. Yeah. Hold on, look at him.
That's the only one so far. So, no, I think he looks like you.
Kick rocks.
Thank you. Thank you.
Kick rocks.
It's the cheekbone.
What about
this gummy bear?
She's got Charlie.
Look at that's the main
one.
Like Audra.
Mom.
Audra. High five.
She's Scooby best friend.
Yeah, right. Hey, give him a high five.
High five, Audra.
She threw a sour patch at you.
Audra, don't do
you gotta
that.
Come over here and watch Cody's for you, baby.
Landon, I thought you was a Colts fan. What you got that stupid Bengals hat
you
on
come
for?
Watch Cody.
Because you know them Bengals.
You got number two.
You know them Bengals. You know them Bengals, baby.
Brittany loves some titties. Who wants to shop for some titties?
Hey, watch your mouth.
What? Steelers.
This is the first video we saw.
I didn't say anything.
Hey, how was your hair? Looks good, TR.
Hey, I need the full blown trim in every direction.
I know it looks really good.
Hey, make sure you're presentable. Hey, make sure you're presentable before the next show.
Hey, just come in front of people dancing in shorty shorts to start everything off. Look like an upside down weeble wobble with a big ass.
We have the best opening of any act of all time. I mean, so people in here better come see our show.
All I know is I let Cody drive my truck earlier, and he had the seat so close to the steering wheel. I said, was there a little boy driving this truck, or what happened?
Did you have to take a phone book out before you got
in? No, it was a mess. He had my daughter's booster seat in the front seat. I'm like, dude, what are you doing?
What are you guys doing?
We were just going over Bible verses. Talking.
You full of shit.
Hey, I said all of us.
You might be able to fool her, but you ain't fooling me, bro.
Why you don't believe me, man?
Because you're full of it.
Hey, the good word today comes from 1 Luke chapter 4, verse 7. And the Lord said, you know what? The Holy Spirit has descended onto the roof.
No, we was reading in Proverbs where it said it's better to live on the corner of a roof than in a house with a nagging wife. And I got to thinking about you, Charlie, and I was praying for you, buddy.
Yeah.
Christine, how was Florida?
Huh?
How was Florida?
Oh, so good. Do you see my tan? I got a tan. Now I'm blonde.
What'd you type anyone?
Nice. Did you do that?
Who the hell keeps saying that? TikTok copyright by 74. I'm blocking your ass because you're full of shit, bro.
What'd they say?
Yeah.
Like your copyright content has been found on your account. Kiss my ass.
Oh, yeah. No, that's all fake shit. All fake shit. Tell him to get a straw so he can suck your ass. Say what? It was good. Nice.
We went to Weezer's. It was a good time.
Thank you for allowing Charlie to come back early so he could be a killer.
You're welcome. I got to enjoy a day without him on vacation.
First of all, we had a great time. Sorry you missed it. You going to the Indiana show?
No, I have a wedding.
Brittany wants them.
Oh yeah, by the way,
do you still want them?
Kingery events. If you need anything booked, please see this young lady right here. Weddings, parties, venues. When I tell you her personality is trash, but she does amazing work when it comes to booking weddings and all this stuff. So listen,
my personality is not.
I'm just kidding. Obviously,
group,
I think you're a great person.
The Kingery Group, Udi.
The Kingery Group,
sorry,
Christine Kingery Events.
Okay, Kingery Group. My bad. Kingery Group or Christine Kingery Events. Make sure you go check this. Even if you don't like the person, marry them anyway.
Go to Google. Go to Google. And then also go to her Instagram thinking events and go follow that ass.
I'm really not mean. I don't know why Udi calls me Louis.
It was a joke, ma'am. You're not mean, okay? It's a joke. Ha ha. I'm trying to unapologetically.
That's the joke at the show. You can't tell the jokes of the show, Christine.
Yeah, thanks for calling me out, Udi.
You can't be coming out here telling the show.
No, that's a good joke at the show. Not, but you did it. I didn't do any of it.
Yeah,
that's facts. Did. Like, that wasn't a lie. Like, that's a fact.
This is a
fact. TR was there. He heard you.
About what?
When she asked us if we ever had BJ's before.
She did. You did ask.
You didn't go with pizza.
You didn't say anything else either. You just said, have y'all ever had BJ's
anybody
before?
BJ's?
Y'all seriously never had BJ's? Why don't y'all want BJ's? Some BJ's? And we were all
BJ's
like,
BJ's is a pizza place. You sick.
We was at
bathroom.
An old man's house. It was a bad situation.
But I do need to let y'all know.
I
never, ever.
Not at the moment.
never ever try St. Elmo's cocktail sauce.
Oh yeah, that's good stuff.
Never, unless you enjoy crying while you're on the toilet.
When is the Indiana show? The Indiana show is May 14th in Fort Wayne, Indiana. You can go
Fort
to
Wayne,
the,
Indiana.
You can go to the
link. Christina's gonna need to plan Rudy's funeral.
Also, if you have not got your tickets for April 22nd, Columbia, April 23rd in Georgia, or Fort Wayne, Indiana, make sure you do so now. You do not want to miss it. Listen, these shows will not be the same. You will see something different. So definitely.
This is what you do.
Hey, hey, hey,
y'all say I'm talking?
Yeah.
Cody, you say I'm talking?
You can go into a different room.
Children are to be seen and not heard, sir.
What's up?
You're wearing earrings from Claire's calling me a child.
Yes.
Grow up.
Hey, buy one, get one free for me and my daughter. Got the same matching pair of diamonds. I ain't no shame in my game.
That's cute.
Yeah, it is cute.
If you could actually find a woman, you have children.
You got those from Claire's.
I said that. Where's Charlie go? He done left you by yourself?
He went to the bathroom. He's fine.
I already told you, on May 13th.
He spent more time in the bathroom than anybody.
I'm staying at y'all's house for that weekend.
I have a wedding May 15th.
Where's your wedding at?
Downtown Indy. So I'm the exact opposite way.
Okay, well, regardless, I'm still staying at your house.
Tell them how much time Charlie spends in the bathroom.
I think Fort Wayne is like an hour from us.
How long does Charlie, Christine, how many hours a day? How much time would you say Charlie spends in the restroom?
I mean, Uta, you've been here enough. Yeah, you know, I told, I like ratted him out about lotioning up when he like gets ready.
And
so
I just
they were like, who's the most high maintenance? And I said, Charlie, because he takes so long. Because you and Scales were both like, why does Charlie take so long to get ready? And I'm like, he has to lotion up.
This man goes into the shower and stays there for like 3 hours. He's got to moisturize every part of his body. Comes out smelling like hot
a
dog.
Dream come true.
No, he smells like hot dog water and cocoa. Pebble.
You ain't gonna talk about him like
that. It's a bad situation. Like,
look at your hair right now.
Cocoa pebbles. What do you mean, cocoa pebbles, bro?
I meant, you know, cocoa butter, whatever.
It's crazy.
Get a haircut, man. Make sure you look fresh for the show.
Right?
Here, talk to y'all for a minute.
No, this is not King Ray's wife.
What's up?
Everyone keeps asking that. Is that King Ray's wife? Nope.
Yeah, it's my wife, my old lady.
I'm the girlfriend.
My old lady, this is my side piece. The hot piece of ass I found on the corner outside
listen,
the liquor
right
store
now,
at 3
a.m. Don't be screen recording this because if Kingery's wife finds out that he's got a side piece, she's going to be super upset.
We're going to be so...
I think Kingery's wife would take a woman
so
out.
So trouble.
Hey, Udi, my kid just brought this to me and said he drew a picture of you.
Hey, that's exactly what I look like, buddy. That is so good. Thank you so much.
You look like Bigfoot.
Oh,
hey.
Hey.
Look at his
earrings.
Hey, Landon, put that on the refrigerator when I come up next month. I'm going to get it, buddy. Also, my son said he wants a rematch in Madden.
Hey, your son, I'll smoke him again.
Listen, I want y'all to know this. Y'all all think I play about these kids. Me and Charlie was playing Madden. Charlie looks at me and he says, I'm about to punch your son in the face. I said, I told you, bro. He don't ever stop.
Right upside the head.
Okay, everyone thinks I have a wig on. I do not have a wig. Everyone keeps saying I have a wig.
I don't
have a wig.
I'm not joking because the one person said that.
I'm not. Look.
What? Why y'all sound like y'all got PAs on your mouth?
PAs. We're looking at Cody's for you, Paige, dude.
Hey,
you want to know what Cody's for you, Paige, has on it?
Yes.
Am I right?
Hey, Daphne, a lot of people want us to come to Pittsburgh, Pennsylvania. Can you make it happen?
I'm sorry, what?
Hi. Hey,
A lot of people want us to come to Pittsburgh, Pennsylvania. Can you make it happen?
Absolutely.
I go to Pittsburgh.
Absolutely. We have shows in June, just so everybody knows, but we'll announce the dates probably tomorrow.
Hey, girl, hey!
We have shows in June in North Carolina and Texas.
She has to check her nursing home schedule to make sure she can leave. But once she does that, she'll book more shows.
You can get on Hamilton or if you want to.
And 86 and get his butt whipped on.
I want to go to Dallas. Let's go to Dallas.
Yeah, we're definitely going to Texas too, Christine. You gotta do better about
that. What about Tampa? Let's go to Tampa.
Christine, do you hear me?
What?
You got to do a better job so you can come to some of these shows, okay?
I'm doing a better job, and I have weddings.
Oh, my God.
Do you know how hard your man is working to provide a better life for you?
Oh.
Thank you. Thank you, Udi. Thank you, Udi. Thank you, Udi.
You got a blue check on everything.
You know? Like, when I told you, it's the unselfishness for me, Charlie, and I appreciate you. The lack of sleep, the hard work.
You know, like, I work hard for this lady, you know, just unselfish as can be, and she just treats me like this.
40 hours a week.
I can't even walk to the refrigerator without her credit card swiping my butt crack like this every freaking time I go. She, you're mine.
What? So what do I do?
I work too.
What do I do?
Right, you work hard. Yes, ma'am.
I work
yes,
really
ma'am.
Hard.
What about it?
The thing when you said about
Bengals.
I said, why you got a Bengals hat on? I thought you liked the coach, buddy.
It's Bengals, not Bengals. What is a Bengal?
Bengal.
What is a Bengal?
The Bengals.
Bang.
Bengal.
B-A-N.
No, Bengal, as in B-E-N-G.
That's Ben.
No, it's a Bengal tiger.
How do you say Ben?
It's a Bengal tiger. Spell Ben? It's not a Bengal.
How do you spell Ben?
It's a Bengal.
How do you spell Ben?
I'm not worried about it.
How do you spell
Ben? Don't yell at me. Don't yell at me. I'm not the one.
What do you want?
It's a Bengal.
Hey, Udi, are you going live at 9:30?
Like hanging out with Mary.
Yeah, what time is it?
It's like 9.
It's 9:22.
Hey, honestly, though, I got a question for y'all. Like, for real question. Why don't y'all live closer? Why do y'all live so far away?
Because we were born and raised here.
But what's in Indiana that's even worth doing?
Nothing.
Me?
Exactly. So you can move to
me,
Virginia.
Me, motherfucker.
Our families.
They can move to Virginia.
Hey,
what's up?
No.
If we were going to move Mike, anywhere, it'd be Florida.
No, Mike is in Indiana. You got to go wherever Mike
is. Yeah, my dad's in Indiana.
We're moving to Florida, bro. We're moving to Florida.
I don't even want to move to Florida.
Mike is Christine's dad, and happens to absolutely be
my dad is one of the best human being on this earth.
Beside my mom.
I like Mama Kingery too, but she's not.
Everyone needs a Mike, a Kathy, and a Vanessa.
That means I might look decent, so then I'll just.
It looks decent.
No, I'm just saying it.
Love you on live PD. Thank you. I appreciate that.
For who's? Matching with you?
Yeah, yeah. I use it as an ego boost. I don't actually go on dates.
He needs an ego boost.
We're looking at his Tinder.
I thought he was on FarmersOnly.com, but he's on FarmersInsideMe.com. I was like, oh, well, that's a little different tale. That's fine.
Whatever. You're a little closer, buddy.
I am, but if you laugh at Udi's jokes, it makes him feel like he's actually funny, so yeah. I just don't laugh.
He don't look the same when his hairline ain't sharp, you don't.
I'll be your hillbilly.
All right, y'all. We're gonna let you go. We're gonna let you go live at 9:30, Udi. We're gonna hop off here.
Love you, buddy.
Right. Love y'all.
Love y'all.
See you, man. See you next week.
Nice
thanks for everybody
you.
That came into our live.
Nice to meet you.
Nice to see you next week. Hopefully we see you next week.
The Kingery Group or Christine Kingery Events. Go follow her on Instagram.
Okay? Instagram. Guys, listen, if you book a wedding and she ain't the inventor. You ain't shit.
You ain't shit. You ain't shit. You ain't shit.